And I didn't really mean take three. What I mean is part three. I labeled one of the videos part one. But it's not really part one. It's actually part two. And I'm going to change that. What happened was one video flowed right into the next. The removal, the last part of the removal of the mount for the engine. And then it went right into the HD axle. Anyhow, enough of that. Let's get down to business. So what I have here is some 99% isopropyl alcohol. It's awesome stuff for cleaning up. And I'm just going to clean this sprocket up real nice. Get any of the excess grease off of it, because the part that I'm about to show you is going to require it to be absolutely spotlessly clean. Because we're going to be putting Loctite on the threads for the one way, and we want, like I said, we want it to be spotless. Okay, so that sprocket is nice and clean. And I'm just going to put the lid back on the... isopropyl alcohol and move it out of the way. And I'm going to take this and set this off to the side as well. And I hope you don't mind, but I'm just going to clean up my little bit of a mess here. We'll just give me a couple of seconds. I want to clean that yet too. This out of the way, put this tool back on the bench. Just cleaning out the grease out of my magnetic parts tray. Okay, that's clean. Grease backward, it's out of the way. And my super clean rag for cleaning the threads. Magnet back, this sheet of metal out of the way. Okay, so you can see what I'm doing here a little better. Just make a small adjustment. And so now we're going to get the wheel out. And I'm going to get some more. I've cleaned grease up with that spot, so I'm going to go to a new spot, because I really don't want any contamination where I'm going to put the thread lock. Okay, so I've soaked the rag down really well, and I'm going to clean these threads the best I can with this alcohol. Okay, so that is prepared for the Loctite. Now, where's the one way? Here we are. I'm going to do the same for the one way. Just stick my fingers in here and rotate this. You certainly wouldn't want to have your bare finger in here, because these threads are full of barbs and biting at my finger, at this rag as we speak. And there is even a risk of a metal shard going in there as I'm doing this. Okay, and I've found another little glob of grease on this. Let's clean it up a little bit more. Oh, you can't even see what I'm doing. How rude. I think what I'll do is pan the camera back a little bit, and you'll get a little more view And I can always pop the camera off and come over and show you a little close-up if I need to. Okay, I'm just going to put the cap back on the isopropyl alcohol. You can pick up isopropyl alcohol by the, well, in the U.S. I think they would call it a pint. But in Canada, I think they call it a liter or milliliters or whatever. And don't be shy and use a good clean rag. Clean that off really well with isopropyl alcohol. I'm going to use this Permatex thread lock. It's blue thread lock. And let's just get down to business here. Okay, so I'm going to take the blue thread lock, and I'm not going to go nuts, but I'm going to put a little band of thread lock all the way around, and I've just basically made a ring. There you go, you can see it. I've made a ring around the inside of the threads. That should be all I need. For that, I'm just going to set this off to the side for the moment. Then I'm going to do a similar thing with the threads for the wheel. And this really should be done. I know I have done the same thing, but I'm at a different level right now. And what I'm saying by I am at a different level, it doesn't mean I think that much more of myself. When I say I'm at a different level, is I am presenting myself as a professional, and everything that I do has to be done right. And if it doesn't, it can have long-term consequences. I'm not going to go into that, what the consequences can be, but it can have long-term consequences. So, in times past, I would have just been as excited as you, and I would have grabbed everything out of the boxes, and I would have been so excited like it was Christmas or a special celebration of some kind, for those people that don't believe in that. And I would be all excited, and I'd be trying to put it together right away without even thinking about using thread lock. Well, like I said, I'm at a different level now. It's not about me, it's about the customer, and it has to be done right. Period. Bar none. Okay? So, there we are. Thread locked. Alright, it's at this point that I'm going to get my pair of gloves on, because these teeth on the sprocket can be really nasty on the bare hands. And I'm going to stand this up, and I'm going to try and put as much force on this as I possibly can. And I'm going to do it this way. And I'm sorry if I'm blocking you. So I put as much force on there as I can. It will likely tighten up more after it's on the bicycle, but that is as much as I could do for that. Okay, so now I need to quickly, I'm not going to do that yet. So now I have fitted the brake drum portion of what PA, you know what, there is confusion about this. Some people call it a band brake and some people call it a drum brake. Well, if you called this a band brake, you wouldn't be wrong. But you know what, also, if you called it a drum brake, you wouldn't be wrong, because guess what, this is a drum. So it's a combination of technology. It's a band brake and a drum brake all rolled into one. And I need to get some more isopropyl alcohol and clean this. Bear with me. Let me see where we are for time. And we are done. Part